Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Donnelly, play-by-play voice of the Charlotte Rush. It is our midweek report on this Wednesday, December the 11th. I'm here in the Charlotte Rush coach's office here at the Extreme Ice Center. We have a lot to get caught up on. We're going to talk Charlotte Rush elite hockey right now. And there was a couple of big wins this past weekend in Raleigh. We're going to have Trevor Jewell recap those for you and a big showcase event coming up. So let's turn now to the head coach and general manager of the Charlotte Rush Elite, Trevor Jewell. And Trevor, first of all, Merry Christmas, season's greetings, a great time of the year, but there's still some more hockey business in hand here, isn't there?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we have about four more games left before break starts.
All right. Well, let's talk about a couple of big wins this past weekend in Raleigh. The Rush traveled there and played their big rival, the Carolina Junior Hurricanes. And Trevor, the Elite got right back on the train with two big wins after a couple of tough losses 2 weeks ago at home to Richmond. Let's talk about game one. It was a 4-3 win. Hayden Ellsbury in goal for you. He had to make 37 saves, so he saw some rubber in that game. And you got four individual goal scorers, which always helps. You spread that wealth around. Spencer Sutera, Blake Witkowski, Kieran St. Ange, and Mike Miller had the goals. Break that one down for us, Trevor.
Yeah, obviously, I think Hayden played really well. I think he started off a little bit slow. He gave up a soft one early, but he rebounded. And he said to me, he's like, I'll make up for it. And he did just that. So, obviously, really happy with his play. I think it shows a lot of our depth as far as having four different goal scorers and stuff like that. But it was a battle for 60 minutes. They kept coming. And we took some penalties and things and got ourselves in trouble. But our PK stepped up and did what they needed to do. Our power play stepped up when we needed them. And our leader stepped up when we needed him. So I thought it was a good game overall, but, you know, we can't afford to have slow starts the way we did and get behind the way we did. But the guys battled, and they came back and were able to win a very good hockey game. And, shaking hands with Brad at the end of the game there, just saying, wow, that was an unbelievable hockey game. It was a lot of fun. It was back and forth. It was just an overall battle, and I think our guys responded, and it shows how well they can actually play when they play for a full 60 minutes. Now, I think if we hadn't taken those penalties, it's a different game as well. Mm.
Well, again, the important thing is the Rush got in the win column with that 4-3 victory. Sunday, they came right back and got a 5-3 win. Jack Lim was in goal. He also made 37 saves. And again, five individual goal scorers for the Rush. Mike Miller scored his second goal in as many games. Quentin Marks, Ivan Korzak, Christian Robel, and Guillaume Lalancette with the goals. And Trevor, for second game in a row, really spreading the wealth out there.
Yeah, I think our guys are starting to play a little bit more complete as a team. And, I think that game's a lot different. We got into some penalty trouble in the second period. I think we had about four consecutive 5-on-3s that we had to kill. And obviously they scored, I think, three of them to tie the game up. And then we got a late one there and got the lead. And then we ended up getting the empty net goal. But very happy with our play, I think. Unfortunately, I mean, even talking to the coaches at the end of the game, I mean, the reffing on both sides was very bad that game. So it's a little unfortunate that they hadn't had an outcome on that game. But we responded. We came back and put another one in the net when we needed it most late in the game there. And, we did everything we could to win that hockey game. It was a battle through and through. Our guys played really well. They responded. And, you know, the energy was good on the bench. I think the guys are really happy. And it just shows how complete our weekend was as far as team play and things like that. So, really happy with those guys, but, you know, we got to carry that momentum into this weekend and make sure that we take care of business before break gets started.
Well, again, kudos to the Rush Elite as they came back after a couple of tough losses at home against Richmond before Thanksgiving to come back and get two big wins in Raleigh against the Carolina Junior Hurricanes. I just took a look at the Southeast Division standings right now in the USPHL Elite League. The Rush right now in second place, as you can see, with 37 points with a record of 18-5-0-1. They are 8 points behind the Richmond Generals, but they have two games in hand. The Carolina Junior Hurricanes also tied with the Rush for the second spot. So those two big wins this past weekend were big. And Trevor, still a lot of hockey to be played yet, and Richmond Generals still in our sights for first place.
Yeah, obviously. I mean, they have a good team over there. We got to start taking care of business and winning the games we have to start gaining some traction against them. But, you know, again, I'm not taking anything away from them. They play well. They play well as a team. They move the puck. They play physical. So, obviously, it's one of those things. It's going to be an uphill battle the rest of the season. I mean, we're only two games over halfway through here. And, I think we still got two games at hand on them. We still have two games at hand on the team we're tied with in Carolina. So we got to make sure we take care of those games when we start making ground on those guys. So it's very important that we win the games we have, you know, coming up. And our guys just have to stay focused and be ready, because obviously we're fighting for, you know, a playoff spot and things like that, and home ice or wherever it's going to be, I guess, just last change, I guess I'll call it. So very, very important that we take care of business this weekend and make sure we keep it rolling through the holidays.
All right, we're going to talk about that upcoming showcase with Trevor Jewell in just a moment. Want to take a look now at the Rush Elite scoring leaders. And at the top, Guillaume Lalancette and Ivan Korzak. They are both tied with 33 points. And also, an important note to make, they are also the top two scorers in the entire Elite League of the USPHL. 33 points. Guillaume Lalancette has 25 lamplighters. And Ivan Korzak, 22 assists. Christian Roble in the third spot with 17 points. Kieran St. Ange, 14. And Trevor, we talk about your two top scorers. Those are first-year players, so kudos on the recruiting of those two guys are really coming up big for you.
Yeah, I mean, they're very important parts of the program, and, you know, they're the future of the program too, obviously, if we don't lose them to a higher level. But, you know, the biggest thing is making sure they stay focused and making sure they don't think things are going to be easy. I think they both need to shoot the puck a little bit more. Obviously, Ivan, he's got a ton of assists, but I'd like to see him start getting some more goals in the goal column. But so, I mean, the meetings with them have been shoot the puck more, stop trying to be so cute and things like that and simplify the game. But very happy with their play, and, you know, when they go, our team goes. So, you know, that's kind of how our games work. So the biggest thing for us is just making sure they stay focused and mentally prepared every single day. And, you know, they do that and they'll be just fine.
All right, we head to Tampa, Florida this weekend for a three-day, four-game showcase. The Rush will be taking on the Florida Eels, Hampton Roads Whalers, also the Atlanta Mad Hatters and the Florida Junior Blades. Trevor, what are you looking for from the guys in the showcase? I know we're going to be in some warmer weather. That'll be a nice start.
Yeah, obviously, I just want to make sure they get down there and compete. You know, there's going to be a lot of eyes on them and things like that. So biggest thing is getting them to play a full 60 minutes, staying out of the box, staying disciplined, and just staying disciplined within the system as well. And moving pucks, getting to the net, doing the little things right. And I think we take care of those things, and we're going to see success all weekend.
All right, Trevor, again, some of the guys are going to be maybe leaving to go home for Christmas break from Florida. The rest of the guys will come back. And what will you be doing over these Christmas holidays? Did you secure that New Year's Eve date yet with Taylor Swift? I heard you were working on that.
No, not at all. I'm coming back here for a day, and then I'm going to go down and visit my family, see my little brother and things like that, and spend some time there. And then I've got to turn around and come back and start preparing for the showcase after the break as well.
Trevor's brother was a member of our Charlotte Rush 2017 championship team, and he'll be home for Christmas from college?
Yeah, finally.
All right, great. That'll be good to see Ross, and want to wish him well in college. He was certainly a big part of our championship team in 2017. Trevor, thanks so much for those observations and updates, and again, good success down at the showcase in Florida, and you have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Thank you. You as well, Tim.
All right, Trevor Jewell, head coach and general manager of the Charlotte Rush Elite. Don't forget to go to our social media platforms for a lot more information on the Charlotte Rush. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. You can also go to our Charlotte Rush YouTube channel. All of our videos are there, our Charlotte Rush website, and also the USPHL website. A lot of wealth of information on the league and the Rush you can find on those sites. Well, again, on behalf of all of us at Rush Nation, our owners, Joshua Langwa, our executive, Julie Crothers, and all of us at the Charlotte Rush, our coaching staff, Trevor Jewell and Jeff Loebman, want to wish all of Rush Nation a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We'll see you on the other side in 2020. I'm Tim Donnelly, play-by-play voice of the Charlotte Rush. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.